Last week, we looked at 1 John chapter 1, verses 1 through 4. We talked about proclaiming the gospel and this proclamation of the gospel being a key to our joy, our completeness, and our communion with God and His Spirit. This week, let's read 1 John chapter 1, verses 5, 6, and 7. This is the message we have heard from him and declare to you. God is light. In him there is no darkness at all. If we claim to have fellowship with him and yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live out the truth. But if we walk in light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, purifies us from all sin. As we proclaim the gospel of Christ, it's important that we understand our objective is to also live the gospel of Christ. We don't want to live a contradiction, claiming Christ, but acting in ways that are unloving, uncaring, ways that lack mercy and grace, the very things that we have received through Christ that make us part of the family of God. If we claim to be in the family of God, then let us live as the family of God. This is the message we have heard from him and declare to you. God is light. Our example, given through Jesus Christ, demonstrates a light that we are to imitate, that we are to follow, a light that we are to embrace. And so, as Jesus tells us in John chapter 13, verse 35, this is how they will know you're my disciples, by the way you love one another. If we want to be light, we have to examine ourselves. We have to claim that fellowship with him and yet walk in the love, the care, the compassion, the fruit of the Spirit, peace, love, joy, long-suffering. We want to demonstrate Christ and reflect the light in the world as we live and walk among our fellows. And so, if we claim to have fellowship with him, we want to continually assess ourselves and move closer and closer to him in our daily walk. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, trusting the Father in all things, resting on the Holy Spirit, striving for love, striving for mercy, striving for grace as we interact in the world, encouraging others to overcome the things that hold them back from being close to God and full communion with God. In other words, our sins. Christ died for our sins, but we continue to try to develop a mindset of moving away from activities that would dishonor God. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, purifies us from all sin. Christ is our grace and our Redeemer. And in honor of that, let us walk each day, examining ourselves and living in the light as he is in the light. Have a great Sunday.